Instead of complaining, I use my imagination. Don't get me wrong. There's lots to complain about in life. But compared to millions of other people around the world, things were pretty good for me. A thorough education, 3 protein-filled meals a day, love and support from family and friends. It could be much, much worse than that. I was 24. Now I'm 16. And working as a support staff in a mediocre company. And despite my general good fortune, I felt like my life wasn't on track yet. Thankfully, I wasn't alone. Every step I took, Umesh, my best friend, was usually there taking it with me. We grew up together, being aware of each other's problems, frustrations, and our darkest secrets. Not that we really had any. We knew what went on in each other's mind. We knew how to complement each other's wit. We knew how to use sarcasm collaboratively. And perhaps, best of all, we knew when silence was the exact right thing to say. Umesh and I have been friends since high school. Since we shared the same last name, Nair, we were roll numbers 86 and 87. Being 87, he always had an advantage to go through my papers over my shoulders during our exams. And if him copying me qualifies as collaboration, then we collaboratively worked towards getting the right answers. Actually, amongst the two of us, I was the hardworking one. But Umesh was the smarter one. To tell you about what Umesh was capable of, let me tell you an incident where, you know, the both of us are involved, obviously. So yes, this was our IT examination. I needed an answer to an objective question. Umesh was right behind me. The answer to the question was A, objective A. Umesh knew the answer. He had copied it from somewhere else. There was about 40 seconds for the bell to go. And the examiner was standing right next to us. Umesh knew the answer. I didn't know the answer. I wanted the answer. I somehow managed. Umesh was helpless. I was restless. 30 seconds to go, the examiner right next to us, he wasn't moving at all. 20 seconds now, I wanted the answer. But suddenly, I heard Umesh go, I didn't write the answer. I was busy laughing. So that is what Umesh is capable of. On a Tuesday in a typical week, I was on my way home from office. Umesh was also on his way back at the same time, which was rare because he often worked for longer hours. Without missing a chance of commuting home together, he called me up. Crossed Wadala, reaching Kurla in 15 minutes over and out. To which I replied, "All right, reaching in 10, which compartment?" "Third from the head," he said. "All right," I said as I hung up the phone to rush to platform number 7 on Kurla station. I got into the third compartment and with a slight nod of my head as an acknowledgement to my friend, we stood on the footboard. We started casually planning the weekend and while we were at it, we reached New Bombay. Many new faces boarded the compartment and flanked the two of us, causing a little restlessness and the occasional leg cramp. Everyone was well versed in commuter behavior, complete complete with the mentality of squeezing for space on the food board, even when there was ample space in the rest of the compartment. Umesh and I couldn't talk effortlessly, as three heads hindered our communication. Being in a second-class bogie, you are always entitled to see some drama. At times, you are even part of it. Most of the times, it's issues like getting your toe crushed, accidentally forcing someone's armpit onto someone's nose. It's disgusting. Not allowing enough space for the fourth guy on the seat. Or as a worst case scenario, finding yourself between two perverts. This mad rush doesn't hinder people from doing what they want. They'll play solitaire, recite a prayer, or argue about politics if they wanted. If they wanted, they probably could find room to celebrate a birthday party also. Umesh poked his head above a newspaper to catch my eye. I saw him and sensed the slightest smirk that nobody could ever make out, and waited for something to happen. Something Umesh knew he was up to. Something was about to happen. "I just hate this," Umesh said loudly with a furrowing brow. "How many times have we told Dad to send the black car to pick us up? Do we have to rely on public transport, sharing this food board, and sometimes sharing my footwear with half of other Bombay?" No offense. It sounded like a genuine rant, which also had some sophistication attributed to it at the same time. It seemed as if all of a sudden Umesh was possessed by a townie. No offense at all. But Umesh had decided to have fun. Hearing his confident jibes on the crowded food board, one of them made way for him. That guy didn't want to be the reason for Umesh's apparent disgust. "What happened to the black car?" he asked. I had no clue what he was talking about. I had to decide whether to participate in this play or act mature. I decided. "It's still being serviced," I said. And now I continued with some confidence. "Come on, after what you've done to the car, do you think it's going to be ready?" As if trying to put Umesh in a spot. Umesh had no clue what he had done to the car. But he did come up with an explanation. "Hey, I was only, you know, trying to drift on the parking lot and it hit the other car. And didn't we pay 35,000 to the other driver?" Umesh now in Salman Khan mode. I replied, "Yeah, we did. You just took it out of your wallet." Umesh continued after more passengers got on. "So the blue car should have been ready by now, isn't it? Why didn't they send the blue car to pick us up?" "Ah, they are still attaching the gold hubcaps." Umesh is now 50 cent with bling on his car mode. All of a sudden, I was his subjugated rich brother, and I was just playing catch up. Our escapade was now gathering an audience. A middle-aged couple stood right next to us, seemingly awestruck. and listening to everything with unblinking eyes. They were starstruck as their faint smile easily conveyed, "We would love to know you. Can we be friends? Or a peek at your blue car?" And we were loving the attention. I said, "Yeah, you know, Dad, we are still grounded. The blue car's coming to the station to pick us up." And Umesh instantly switched to Justin Bieber mode. "Damn, what's wrong in committing mistakes at this age, dude?" He added, "Isn't that what we are supposed to do?" "Forget it. I'll buy a new car. I won't even tell Dad about it." I shook my head. I shook it at Umesh's exaggeration. But for the couple, I shook it, disgusted with our father. "Screw it. The blue car is coming, right?" "Yes, it is," I said. "Better. This is the last time I'm sharing my ride with anyone." Umesh finally ending it with the Paris Hilton mode. After a few minutes, the bogey emptied a little. The awestruck couple was still there, looking at each other, but also wondering if he had anything else to say. Just then, our stop arrived. We ran towards the share auto rickshaw stand, laughing our heads off. Back then, Umesh and I only owned a cycle. I mean, we owned one cycle together. We had no other vehicle. And here we were behaving as if we were an offspring of the Ambanis and Salman Khan. "Your own car? Really? Sell your rented house first," I said, laughing uncontrollably as we ran away from the sight of our fellow commuters. We made our way through the short line and into a shared auto. Umesh sat behind and I shared the driver's seat. "Man," I exclaimed, you know, waiting for a reply or a laughter in reciprocation to celebrate this act. I got none. Umesh was dead silent. "Dude, how was..." I stopped. Umesh was looking out to the side. What he witnessed was horrifying. Right next to him was the awestruck couple. How did they get there so fast? I think they had teleported themselves into the queue. Or I think it probably was the blue car they wanted a ride. They chased us. Earlier, they were deceived. Now they were disgusted. They stared at us as if we betrayed them. Their silence was heavy and accusatory. Every space we had made on the food board was on the basis of lies. They now understood. We were liars. I was waiting for a confrontation any moment as their eyes bore into us. But just then, as the rick was about to pull away, Umesh, my Salman Ambani friend, said, "Tell him to send the red one the next time." Thank you.